Okay, it's December 28th, 2015. Almost a new year. See, this is what I call the Chemtrailed Rain. And when I split the skies, a couple days ago, I kept saying that we're going to overcast. It's been raining. I did a video earlier. I'm going to put down Chemtrailed Rain 1, Chemtrailed 2, and if they do another one, it'll be 3. This will be the second one. But see, I told you there'd be lakes out here. It's not plugged in to the power source over there. I can't really get out there. I'm not going out in the rain. I don't want it in my scalp or anything like that. But the number two garden, the small right one. This is number one right here, the small left. It's got a puddle on the edge over there, but I can't see it from here. You can see barely on number one right there. It's puddles on that. I mean, it's keeping the majority of the rain from going right in. It's soaking in the ground regardless, folks. But, I mean, I'm a stickler about this stuff. This plastic's going to go on that garden right there. But, you know, right there, you see it right there from the edge here. It goes along the house. It's not as long as it was. But it still can get about 15 to 18 pepper plants in it. So, this is the Chemtrailed Rain after results of it. And like I said, with the wind out here, I don't know how bad it's affecting the mic, because sometimes some of the stuff I'm saying is getting cut out completely. And see all that water. And this is 10 o'clock in the morning, a couple minutes before 10 o'clock on December 29th, 2015. So we still got some rains allegedly coming. I don't know how much more. We were supposed to have more than this, actually. But, you know, man, God kind of diverts some of it here and there sometimes. Not that he's doing it purposely either, but, you know, it's all saturated down here in the ground. Even our reservoir here is about, well, it was about 4,700 gallons of water in there, a little bit more than that, actually. It's getting all this rain water into it too, this Chemtrailed Rain water. So call me paranoid, whatever. You know what? When you're coughing up a lung, I'll remember that. But I won't say a word. Anyway, there you go. This is the second video of three. I did one. I was telling you how it's going to be flooded out here. And there was a small one right on the other side over there. It's expanded more all the way there. All right, all that one in the middle there. That's probably the one in front of the station line over there. And look out there on the other side. That goes to the other entrance. Off the road, which is flooded right there. And we have it running across our ditch out front also. So there you go. We're an experimental lab for these insane things out there that are using us as guinea pigs. And you're okay with it, so. Again, I don't hear any gunshots. I don't see anybody, even though the media is squashing most of this anyway. They aren't going to tell you anything. They've been bought out for a long time now. That's why they're going full force with all this stuff. They used to be more independent and they would report stuff. What's his name? I can't think of his name now. The guy from, he was on Channel 2. But he used to do really good. He even said something about 9-11. How the buildings look similar to those buildings that come down in Las Vegas when they did the controlled demolition. Guess what? All of a sudden they pulled his butt right off the air. He does guess things now. He's probably made an agreement with them. But they got his butt off the air right away, man. Dan Rather is his name. Dan Rather. I kept thinking of his name as I was facing my head. So, you know, they try to say something and they'll ruin your career. They'll if you don't have any fear, they'll go after your families. But, you know, if everybody were to unite, they cannot. There's no way in the world they could ever fight against a united front. That's why they're going to autonomous drones, because they know men will make decisions to sometimes not fire on Americans. Hello. But a drone just does whatever is programmed into them. So that's part of it. Call it paranoid or whatever you want. Conspiracy is not conspiracy. They just use that as a reason to disturb people, make people think, oh, nutcase. No, it's not. It's not nutcase at all. A conspiracy just means that well, when they say you're a conspiracy theorist, you just know it's not right, and you're trying to point that out, but the majority of people are stupid, unfortunately. Not stupid, they're ignorant, because you don't know better. You're not stupid, you're ignorant. But when you're told and you're shown the information, and you don't look it up yourself, then you become stupid, because you won't do what you know you should be doing. That's the flooding out here of the Chemtrailed Rain. Everybody have a safe New Year. If it rains later today, I'll get out here either today before it gets too dark, and then or tomorrow morning, and do the third one, the third and final video.